Watch as this creature moves. Notice its long, legless body, its smooth scales, its flicking tongue. This is a Western rat snake, and it is a member of the reptile family. There are over 3,000 species of snakes living all over the world in different habitats. In Nebraska, there are around 30 species of snakes living in prairies, forests, and even wetlands. In this video, we'll dive into what makes snakes so special by learning about their adaptations. What are adaptations? Adaptations are physical structures or behaviors inherited by their parents that help that animal or plant survive in its habitat. Adaptations can be physical, or something the animal has on its body to help it live, such as a snake's eyes help it see. Or adaptations can be behavioral, or something the animal does to help it survive, like how a snake detects a predator and slithers away. Adaptations help plants and animals do many different things to survive, such as move, eat, regulate their body temperature, avoid predators, or have offspring. One of the first things that people notice about snakes isn't what they have, it's what they don't have. Legs. But even without legs, snakes can move very quickly through grass, across sand, up across trees, or even through water. So without legs, how do they do it? With their long, flexible bodies. This includes a long spine with up to 400 ribs attached. Large belly scales, or scutes, help the snake grip, while muscles attached to the ribs help the snake climb, swim, and even climb trees. Snakes rely on their senses to hunt and avoid predators. Notice that tongue flicking? The snake is smelling its surroundings. It flicks its long, forked tongue to pick up chemical molecules from the air, ground, and even water. The tongue carries those smelly molecules back to small openings in the roof of its mouth called a vomeronasal organ, where the snake analyzes the molecules to figure out the source of the smell. If snakes smell with their tongue, then how do they hear? With their jaws. Snakes don't have external ears like we do to pick up sound waves in the air. Instead, bones in their lower jaw pick up vibrations on the ground and in water, and then send the signal to the snake's brain, alerting them, among other things, when prey is near. Snakes are predators and can often hunt and eat things wider than themselves. How they manage to do this again comes down to their well-adapted jaw. Unlike a mammal's jaw, which is built for force, a snake's jaw is built with tendons and ligaments that allow for ultimate flexibility. Snakes are ectothermic, or cold-blooded reptiles. This means they have no way to stay warm in the winter. To survive colder winter months, they brumate. Brumation, which is similar to hibernation, is when a snake's metabolism, or energy-creating system, slows way down. Snakes, like many other reptiles, will spend their winters sheltered in holes, leaves, trees, or wood piles in a state of brumation. As you can see, snakes have many incredible adaptations to help them survive in their habitats, from their long bodies, to their unique skulls, to their ability to conserve their energy in the cold winter months. And remember, next time you're outside, take time to observe the plants and animals all around you, from bugs to birds, flowers, and trees. What adaptations do you notice? And how do you think those adaptations help that animal survive?